The focus of this course was on understanding the physics of internal compressible flows, where a compressible fluid flow is confined by the walls of an internal passage. Transportation of natural gas, airflow through inlets and nozzles of aircraft and spacecraft are a few well-known examples of internal compressible flows. In this course, we first explored 1D flows with heat addition and frictional effects, which are known as Rayleigh and Fanno flows respectively. We saw that the heat addition and friction always drive the Mach numbers towards 1, that is, they decelerate a supersonic flow and accelerate a subsonic flow. Next, we studied some important aspects of quasi-1D compressible flows having variable area, such as flow through converging and diverging ducts. Here, we saw that subsonic flows accelerate through converging and decelerate through diverging passages, whereas on the other hand, supersonic flows decelerate through converging and accelerate through diverging passages. We have also studied the concepts of choking and critical flow properties. Building on this theory, we studied the case of converging-diverging nozzles, which are used in high-speed propulsion systems such as afterburners of jet engines and rocket engines to accelerate gases to higher subsonic speeds. We identified different flow behavior based on the operating conditions of nozzle and discussed in detail about the dynamics of fluid flow for each of these conditions. We then covered diffusers that are used to decelerate the fluid flow. We discussed the differences between ideal and real diffusers and discussed the starting problem in the context of supersonic wind tunnels. Finally, we studied about the method of characteristics, which was the go-to tool before the advent of advanced numerical and computational techniques, and explored how we can use this method to design an ideal supersonic nozzle.